Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing sequence and series, and this is the lecture number 16. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 15 before watching this part 16. In this lecture, we will solve some questions related to applications of arithmetic and geometric progressing. So let us write some questions, and thereafter we will write some solutions as well. So starting from question number 27. This is given that a farmer buy a tractor. A farmer buy a tractor for rupees 12,000. He pay 600 rupees. He pays 6,000 cash and agree to pay the balance in annual installment of rupees 500 plus 12% interest on unpaid amount. Round. How much will the tractor cost him? This is the question. Now we have to deal with this question that he has paid 6,000 and remaining 6,000 in 12 installments. So the first installment amount paid, cash paid 6,000 and amount paid in first installment will be 500 plus interest on 6,000, because 6,000 was balance into 12 into 1/100, that is 2020 cancel. So 500 plus 12 6 are 720. So 500 plus 720 is equal to 1220 rupees. Amount paid in second installment, because 500 out of 6,500 he has paid. So now the remaining 5,500 is left, and interest on that you have to pay. So that will be 660. So that will be 1160, right? So this way it will come every times. The interest will be on 5,000. The third installment will be like 500 plus, now balance will be principal is 5,000, 12 into 1 by 100. So that will be 600 plus 500 is 1100, and so on. So amount paid installment is equal to, therefore amount paid in installment, how many installment will be there? Sixth installment will be, first installment is, first installment is 1200, 12 installments, 6 installments are 1220 plus 1160 plus 1100. So this is in AP, because difference of 60 is every times. So that will be 6 by 2 into 2A, 12 into 20 plus 6 minus 1, that is 5, into D is minus 60. So it will be minus 60. That will be 3 into 2440 minus 300, right? So that will be 3 into, that will come up 3 into 2140, that is 4 3 are 12, and 21 3 are 63 plus 1 64, 6420. And therefore total cost of tractor him is 6,000 rupees cash plus 6,420 installment. That is 12,420 rupees. That will be the answer. I hope you got it. Now the next question is here, and question number is, next question is question number 28. Here also it is given that a man buy a scooter for rupees 22,000. He paid 4,000 rupees in cash and agreed to pay annual installment of rupees 1,000 plus 10% interest plus 10% interest on unpaid plus 10% interest on unpaid amount. What is the cost of a scooter for him, right? So this is a similar question, and you can do it again. 1,000 rupees installment for remaining 18,000. There will be 18 installment, so 18,000 will be paid. And what will be the interest on every time? The interest amount paid in interest. Let me write in something different way. Cash is 24,000, and installments are like 1,000 plus an amount paid in installments are like 1,000 paid installments are 1,000 plus 18,000 was balance, multiply by 10 divided by 100. This is the first installment. Second installment will be 1,000 plus 17,000 money will left, multiply by 10 divided by 100, and so on till 18th term. 18 installment, there will be 18 term. So that will come up here, 1,000, and here 2020 cancel, so 1,800, so it will be 2,800. That will come here, 2,800 plus 2,700 plus 2,600, like that up to 18 terms, right? Now here common difference is minus 100, and first term is this. So here you can write 18 by 2, 2a, that is 2 times of 2800 is 5,600, plus 18 minus 117 into d is minus 100. So we can write 9 into 50 is 5,600 minus 1700. It will be 9 into, this will be 3900, 3900, right now? So that will come here, 9 9 81, and 9 3 27, and 8 35,100. He pays 35,000 9 3 9 9 81, and 35 9 3 27 plus 8 is 35,100 in installment plus 4,000 cash. So the total cost of a scooter for him. The total cost of a scooter for him is 4,000 cash plus 35,100 in installment. So 39,100 will be the cost for him. That will be answer. I hope you got it. Now the next question I would like to take on, that is question number 30. And what is that? Try to understand. in question number or 29 even first. Before doing 30, I should go for 29. So 29 question is there. Now this is the question. A man writes four letters to his friends and ask them to copy and send to their four friends except him with the same instruction, right? Find the cost of postage when eighth set of letter is dispatched. If the cost of postage a stamp on each letter is 50 paisa, is 50 paisa, right? This is question. So how to deal with this question? The first set of letter, four letters, is being sent. Number of letters sent, like first one is 4. Man sent 4 letter and this is 4 letter, right? Chain will form like this. Try to understand. The first person sent 4 letters, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yes. And they will send 4 letter to each. So in second set of letter, there will be 16 letters, right? Now here each one of them will send 4. So first time there will be solution is that 4 letter is sent, then 16, each one of them is 4, then 64, like this till eighth term. So eighth term of the sequence is T8 is equal to AR to the power 7, isn't it? So that is 4 into 4 to the power 7. That is 4 into 4 to the power 7. That is 4 to the power 8. Right now? So completely this is 4 to the power 7. Number of letters. And this is total value. 4 to the power 8 is the total value. 4 into 4 to the power 8. 7 is the total number of letters. And cost of postage will be like, so therefore cost of postage in 4 into 4 to the power 7 letters at rate of 50 paisa, that is 1 by 2 rupee, is given by 1 by 2 into 4 into 4 to the power 7. So this is cancelled 2 times, 2 into 4 to the power 5 is 1024, into 4 to the power 2 is 16. So that will be, I think this will be 2048 into 16, it will be 16 at 128. And 12, 16, 4 just 64, and 2, 68, 78, 7. So, right now, and 16, 2 just 32. So, 32,728 rupees, that will be the answer. That will be 32,768 rupees, that will be the answer of this question. So, now the next question is, a man deposit rupees 10,000, question number 30. A man deposited rupees 10,000 in a bank at the rate of 5% per annum simple interest. in a bank at the rate of 5% per annum. Annum, simple interest. Simple interest. Simple interest. Right. Find the amount in the 15th year. Find the amount in the 15th year. In the 15th year, since he deposited the amount. Since he deposited the amount. The amount. And also calculate the total amount after 20 years, and also calculate the total amount after 20 years, amount after 20 years, right? In first year, his amount is rupees. In first year. First year, his amount is, his principal is rupees 10,000, and rate of interest is 5% per annum, right? Although it is not mentioned that it is a compound interest, but annually it is written that per annum simple interest, that is annually it has been added in the principal. So amount after first year, amount after 1 year, after 1 year will be 10,000 principal plus interest on 10,000 at rate of 5% per annum. This is the simple interest. So you can calculate 10,500. 10,500. Amount after 2 year will be 10,500 will be the principal. And then on this 10,500, there will be, but this will be the compound interest. So it will be 10,500 plus 500. Every year the interest is 500 will be accumulated in that. Right now, that is no compound interest, but 500 interest will be compounded added every year. So after 2 years, it will be 10,500, because it is not compound interest, plus 10,000 into 5 into 1, because interest in simple interest, interest will remain fixed. So 500 again, so that would be 1100, 11,000, and so on, etc. Right now, so interest will be here, the sequence will be like 10,500 after 1 year. 11,000 after 2 years, 11,500 after 3 years, 12,000 after 4 years, like this. So after 14 year, that is in 15th year, right? Now after 14 year, T14 of that age, T14 is 10,500, right? Now plus 13 into 500, that is 10,500 plus 6,500. 17,000 will be at the amount after 14 years, that is in 15th year. 15th year. And after 20 years, it will be T20 is equal to 10,500 is first term and 19 into 500 here. A plus N minus 1 into D. So 19,5 is 9,500. So 10,500 plus 9,500, it will be 20,000. Right now? So answer is 20,000. I hope you got it. Now the next question is given here. That is question number 31. Question number 31 is there. A manufacturer recons. A manufacturer. Manufacturer recons a manufacturer recons that the value of machine, that the value of machine, machine, which cost him to, which cost him to, cost him to 15,625 will depreciate, will depreciate, depreciate, right, would depreciate each year, depreciate each year, depreciate each year by 20%. Find the estimated value at the end of 5 years. Find the estimated value, estimated value, estimated value at the end of 5 years. Find the estimated value at the end of 5 years. End of 5 year. So you can write here, at the end of 1 year, the value will be how much? Solution can be calculated as, at the end of 1 year, end of 1 year, the value will be 15,625 minus 15,625 into 20 into 1 by 100. That is 5 times can cancel and 5 can cancel this. 5 3 is 15, 5 1 is 5, and 5 2 is 10, and 5 5 is 25. So 3,125. So it will be 2500, and this will be 5, and this will be 12,500. So at the end of 1 year, the cost will remain 12,500. Similarly, at the end of 2 year, at the end of second year, it will be what? 12,500 minus 12,500 into 20 into 1 by 100. Again, 2020 cancels out, so that will be 12,500 minus 2,500. So 2,500. So what will remain? 10,000. I hope you got it. Similarly, after third year, depreciation after third year will be what? T3 will be 10,000 minus 10,000 into 20%, 20 into 1 by 100. So what will happen? This will be 2020, that is 2000 will depreciate. So that will be 8000, isn't it? So every time this value will decrease by same. And after fourth year, that will be after fourth year, you can have like 8000 minus 20% of 8000, that is 20 by 100. That is 1600 will depreciate, so that will be 6400 will left. And at the end of fifth year, the money will remain 6400 minus 6400 into 20 by 100, and that would be 2020. So that is 6 to 12, 80. 1280, if I'll subtract, that will be 5120, and that will be answer of this question. You can use it directly, the formula of depreciation, that amount after 4 year will be principal into 1 minus r by 100 to the power time. You will get it that the value is 15,625, and 1 minus 20 by 100 is 80 by 100, 80 by 100 is 4 by 5 to the power 5, and that will be 15,625, and that will be 4 to the power 5. 4 to the power 5 is 1024, divided by 5 to the power 5 is 3125. 3125. right now. So that can cancel 5 times and the value will be 5.20. So that is a direct way to calculate. This is a direct method, but because this is given in AP, so we need to calculate it like that, direct method. Now the last question, which is given here, 32, and 32 is given like 150 workers engaged to finish a job in certain number of days, four workers dropped out on the second day. Four workers drop out on second day, and four more workers are dropped out on third day, and so on. Hence, it took 8 more days to finish the job. Right? Find the number of days in which work was completed. Right? So let the number of workers solution in the first day is 150, next day 146, third day 142, and like this up to n plus 8 days. Now it is n days. Let work was finished in n days. Right? So the total number of workers in n days will be like this. If it was not nobody is left out, then work was to be finished in n minus 8 days. So total number of labors will be 150 per day in n minus 8 days. This will be the total number of labors, and this will be the total number of labors which is working for n days if every day 4 workers being dropped out. Okay, this is the total number of labors which took actual to finish the job, and this is what they estimated. Both of them, the number of labors are same. So you can use it n by 2, because this is an AP, 2a plus n minus 1, and d is here minus 4, is equal to 150n minus 1200. Can I write like this? Okay. Now that will be, this is 300 and plus 4, 304 divided by 2 is, that is 2n square, because it will be minus 4. So minus 2n square multiply by n, minus 2n square, and that will be minus minus plus. So 300 plus 4 divided by 2 is 152n minus 150n plus 1200 is equal to 0. Right now, so we can do this as n square minus, this is plus 2n, which will come this side minus n, and if you divide by 2, that will be minus 600. All of them will come this side. It will be minus 600 is equal to 0, right? Divide by 2, and then it will be this employee n minus 25 and n plus 24 is equal to 0. This employee n is equal to 25, since n cannot be minus 24. So the work is completed in 25 days. So number of days the work is completed. Therefore, work was completed in 25 days. That will be the answer. I hope you got it right now. So these are some application based questions, and hopefully you have enjoyed this. And this, there is a lot of application of AP and GP. There is one good news that this type of questions is usually asked in competitive examinations like SSC, Bank PO, and CAT examinations for IIM, and also in civil services examination also. So there are great applications of these formulas and this concept. Enjoy this and memorize this for future reference as well. It will be useful in competitive examinations when you will be passed and try for some government job, then also it will be useful. So thank you very much for watching this. This is all about the sequence and series for class 11th and for JE examination, main and advanced. The topic will be continued in the next few lectures. Right now, a lot of things have to be discussed for JE level. But for 11th class, this is all about in sequence and series. So thank you. Thank you very much for watching this. God bless.